Welcome to this CSS tutorial, and in this tutorial we're going to talk about formatting text with CSS. And basically what we're going to use is EM instead of PX, which is pixels. So there's really two ways to do that. One is you can use EM, which is basically relative length units. And that's sort of where things are going now. More and more people are using EM as the main way to determine their margin size and their font size and their padding size. That's really where it's going. They're using relative length units because mainly those scale better between the different mediums that people might be using. And that's really the problem today. You've got so many people using these different devices. You've got people on mobile phones, you've got people on desktops or people that prefer tablets, and even some people that use TVs for the internet. So you have all these different mediums, these rendering mediums. So it's really good now to use relative length units. And EM has sort of become the big standard. Not PX anymore. Now PX, of course, you can still do that, and if that's what you prefer, certainly feel free to do that. PX, of course, is an absolute length. You're sizing your margins or your font size with an absolute length, whereas EM is a relative length. So once again, it scales better. That type of length unit scales better between the different mediums. So that's what we're going to do in this lecture. We're going to actually use EM. So you can see I've got this very basic page with a lot of text because we want to work against a lot of text, right? We want this like some article that somebody might be looking at. So we're going to go ahead and use EM. So what I'm just going to do is use the body selector and the paragraph selector. Now, if you want to go ahead and add classes to these, feel free. You should know how to do that by now. If you've followed my tutorial series on CSS, that should be relatively easy. But we're really concerned about EM again in this video, so we're going to go ahead and use those. So I've got those right here. So let's go ahead and actually, let's now minimize this. And I've got a live server up here so we can get the active changes. So you can see here, we've really got nothing styled. This is sort of just right against the edge of the page. And what we want to do now is get a nice little margin around here using EM. So let's go ahead and put in a margin around that text. So really this makes it a little bit more readable. And what we're gonna do is put in 5 EM. That's what we want. Again, we want this to be relative. And look at that. Now this is a little bit more readable, right? This text isn't crunched up right against the edge of the screen and it scales. That's the great thing. Look, that's scaling really nicely now. To whatever size or medium that the person who's reading this article has. And that's the great thing about EM again. You really want to get in the habit of using this as opposed to some absolute length unit like pixels. You really want to start to use EM more and more. Now, one thing I found is, and you can do what you want here, but one thing I like to do is take a little bit off the top usually. So what I'll do is I'll come in and I'll specify a margin top. And, you know, we can put in a lower value here. Let's put in something like 3 EM. So we'll shave a little off the top. And I always like the way that looks a little bit better. Now, keep in mind with CSS, the more specific you are, CSS will take that version of it. So basically, this will now override what is specified here at the top. Nowhere else, it will still apply that margin 5 EM on both sides and the bottom, but what we're doing here is shaving a little bit off the top. And again, CSS will take the most specific setting. So that's what's happening here. So again, this is sort of a standard way to do things now in terms of centering your text. Now, we could go ahead and work with the fonts in the body, but let's go ahead and we'll actually put a setting in our paragraph selector. So we're gonna affect all of the paragraphs, all three of these paragraphs. And what we're gonna do is specify font size. And let's set this to the absolute standard. And this is the standard most people are using today. Most people are setting their font size at 1.5 EM. This is a very standard setting today, again, that a lot of people are using. So I would, again, highly recommend that you use 1.5. You don't see a lot of people using 1 EM. That doesn't really make a lot of sense. So again, this is sort of a big standard now. A lot of people using 1.5 EM to size their fonts. I will also point out that most people will also use a margin of 1.5 EM. Now, again, this is really preference. I don't like that with my articles. And so when I'm designing my web pages, I usually like a bigger margin. I like to give a lot of space. I kind of like this to look like a Kindle almost, like you're reading on one of those Kindle readers where you got, you know, they give you a lot of space from the edges. But again, you could put in 1.5 em here. And again, that is the standard. So I'm kind of breaking that, but really it's feel. It's what you like. And, you know, you can get feedback from the people that are looking at your web page. That's always good to do. What do they prefer? You don't necessarily have to follow the standards. You can find out what they prefer and act accordingly. So again, this scales really nicely, as we can see. It's scaling really, really nicely here. Now, you can also add in a line height, and I tend to do that quite a bit. I usually like to size that a little bit less than the font size. So what I'll do is I'll come in here, and usually I'll put this at about 1.2 to 1.3 em. And you can do what you want. Again, this is preference. You know, you might make this a little bit less, but you can see this makes it a little bit easier on the eyes for your reader. It's a little bit easier to get to the next line. All the sentences aren't crunched up right against each other. Okay, that's going to do it for this lecture. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks as always for watching.